My name is Tapansha. I'm from Micro Focus, and I'm responsible for product management for network operations management. DNA as an open platform is driving a significant meaning for our customers, and they are quite excited that DNA is an open platform driven by the REST APIs, and then the Micro Focus is consuming those APIs to drive the monitoring and the provisioning use cases. What we are doing is we are integrating with Cisco DNA Center as a bidirectional integrator. So we first get the network events out of the DNA Center and then consume them into our software portfolio and then provide the application impact, which could be potentially due to a fault at the network layer. And at the same time, we detect the fault, and then once we understand the application impact, we remediate the fault using the provisioning APIs that DNA Center provides. So the use case that we are covering is literally a trade show use case. You have a bunch of users floating around on the floor, and then they are all connecting to the Wi-Fi on the Cisco Live Events application on their mobile. And what we are trying to showcase here is that if there was a WLAN configuration issue, and that stopped the clients from roaming from one area of the trade show to the other area of the trade show, that would clearly show the dip in the number of clients that are registered to the application or getting online under the applications. And then that application impact, how we can resolve it by, again, fixing or reprovisioning the WLAN using the DNA APIs. So this way, we make DNA as the true source of telling us what's going wrong. So that is detecting the problem as well as remediating the problem by providing the provisioning capability. On the demo, you can see here that we have the trade show health dashboard, which includes the health statistics from DNA. It includes the health statistics from the network operations management, which is around the compliance. And then we have the mobile application health statistics all coming into one dashboard. And then you see that there's something going wrong with the mobile application health with a sudden user drop. You drill down, you get into the details, you look at the monitoring dashboard, and you clearly see that there is a security KPI which is impacted in here, and that's the impact at the network layer, which propagates all the way to the mobile application. And then you see that, hey, there is a client failed to roam event. That's actually the event that's coming from DNA, and that seems to be the potential root cause at the network layer, which is causing the users to drop on the mobile application. So you see this cause-symptom relationship, the events coming out of DNA, and then I want to get into the layer 2 network topology just to see how all the devices are connected. So you see that there is a wireless LAN controller connected to the switch and the router on the uplinks, and then I want to now look at the next level of details, because DNA provides a pretty in-depth network monitoring data. So let's look at the overall health dashboard of DNA Center. You can clearly see that at a network layer, about 77% devices are healthy, and then 63% clients are healthy. So let's look at the details of what's going on. You can clearly pinpoint that there are only 46% healthy wireless clients. So okay, let me drill down into details. These are the physical links, and now I see the exact set of clients which are currently having the problem. I can pinpoint that there are two clients which are having the onboarding health issues, and then now I know that, yeah, this could be a widespread issue, and that's probably the reason why the users are dipping down on the application. So let me go back here, look at the compliance. I can pinpoint that there is a security compliance violation. So this is all DNA's monitoring that's driving our workflow to figure out what's going wrong. Look at the WLAN security compliance, figure out the exact line of code which is going wrong in the WLC configuration, and then you go and remediate that by reprovisioning a WLAN, by providing it a profile, the same SSID, and then invoking the DNA APIs to essentially first delete the SSID and then create the new SSID with the correct security provisionings. You deploy this, you go back to the dashboards, dashboards turn green, security is back to normal, the events are back to normal, the topology looks all normal, and then after a while, you start seeing that the users start coming on upwards. So the idea here is that, I mean, it's the DNA, which is now the true source that provides and detects the network problem. And then the Micro Focus tools figure out the impact of that network problem at the application health level. And then it's DNA that helps us remediate the problem and thereby completing the end-to-end cycle of detection and remediation of a wireless network problem, which is impacting a bunch of end users accessing the Cisco Live Mobile application. Please visit the Cisco DNA Ecosystem Exchange to learn more about our solutions and to contact us.